The different styles of beer are determined by their ingredients. Different yeasts, you have cold fermenting yeast and warm fermenting yeast. Warm fermenting yeasts are your ale yeasts, cold fermenting yeasts are your lager yeasts. The characteristics of the beer starts with what kind of yeast you want to use. Then you've got different kinds of grains. You have malted, unmalted, wheat, barley, rye. Those typically are used in various combinations. Your base malt is normally a barley malt. Typically it's 80% of your finished beer. Then the other 20% of your grist, you would call it, is all of the grains put together, are various kiln grains. First you have to malt the barley, which is changing your basic seed and soaking it in water. As soon as that seed sprouts an endosperm, that has the chemical reaction inside the seed that creates all of the starches. So you can also take that grain and cook it. You cook it by various kilning means. There's wet kilning, there's dry kilning. But what you're doing is you're trying to convert a lot of those starches to sugars. If you were to boil sugar in water, you caramelize things. Caramelize onions, you caramelize meat, you caramelize everything to anything you add heat to get the carbon chains in there to convert to different types of sugar. You'll get the different flavor characteristics. The longer you cook something, the more caramelization you'll create, and the darker the grain actually becomes. You'll burn it. And you take those grains and combine them with the water in a mash. So you'll mash your grains to convert all of those starches to sugars. Once you have that conversion taking place, you'll take all that liquid with the sugars in it and move it to your boiling pot. So once it's in your boiling pot, that's where you add your spices, your hops. Even as a home brewer, you can be as creative as you want. I put ginger, I put cinnamon, I put nutmeg, I put all kinds of different spices as well as hops into the boil to create whatever kind of flavor profile I would like. After you boil your wort, as it is at that point, you release various oils from hops or oils from the other spices and you infuse them into your beer. You can add them at different points in the boiling process to provide the flavor profile that you'd like. Once it's boiled, you can chill it and add your yeast. Yeast can only survive in temperatures typically less than 100 degrees. So going from a boiling to a chilled state for a home brewer, there's all kinds of methods to do that. And there's immersion chillers. You can have industrial plate chillers. Whatever means necessary. You can set a big pot of boiling wort out in the snow or outside, and it'll chill eventually. And then once it's chilled, you can add your yeast. Once the yeast gets in contact with all of those sugars in that wort, they go to town. They reproduce, they consume, and they suspend. So they produce alcohol and carbon dioxide in the normal breakdown of that sugar chain. Once you have your finished beer product, it's not carbonated. We enjoy carbonating our beer, and there's various levels of carbonation that you can impart into that beer at the end. You can naturally re-ferment it in a bottle. You can, by adding sugar and letting whatever suspended yeast is still in there to carbonate naturally. You can force carbonate by putting it in a tank and putting CO2 pressure on it. The differential in pressure, the liquid will absorb the CO2. And then once it's in that finished state, you can either pop open a bottle, or as I prefer in my beer fridge at home, I open up the tap. My favorite styles of beer are typically Belgian style beers. I think brewing is the perfect marriage of science and art and creativity. On one side, you have the German, very stylistic version of beer, which back in the 1600s, they mandated you will only use water, hops, barley, and yeast in their beer. The Belgians were a little more creative about that. They're like, flowers? Sure, put them in. Spices? Sure, put them in. It's all about flavor. If you come from a background where you have the low alcohol, low flavor, we call them fizzy yellow beers in the craft brewing industry, you get opened up to a whole variety of different flavors. And I think beer is a great vehicle for a many, many flavors. And Belgian beers, for me, provide that flavor profile that I prefer. The yeast strain is a Belgian yeast strain. You'll get natural yeast occur all over. There's a Native American yeast, there's German yeast, English yeast, Czechoslovakian yeast, African yeast. They all naturally occur in and around most breweries, or any brewery, or in your house. Belgian strains provide a fruity, estery profile that provides a little bit of extra flavor when combined with a different kind of malt. So Belgian-style beers are my favorite. And then I would English styles and American styles have been recently very heavily hopped. If you like a hoppy beer, there are very many American styles on the East Coast and the West Coast that provides you all the hop bombs that you'd like to drink. So.